In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Augustine. We ask his prayers that we may always experience God never giving up on us, even in our struggles and even in our sinfulness, even in the struggle of being faithful to Him. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgive sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Renew in your church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit with which you endowed your bishop, Saint Augustine, that filled with the same spirit, we may thirst for you, the sole fount of true wisdom, and seek you, the author of heavenly love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brothers who walks in a disorderly way and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us. For we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we work so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my way, in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in His ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold us in the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous. And you say, 'If we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood.' Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
If we are to train someone to be the best, and at least to make them capable of living every day, we need someone who will never give up on a particular person. Mahirap maging mabuting manlalaro, artista, pare, empleyado, estudyante, na hindi natin tinatanggap ang mga sinasabi at mga patunay ng mga tao sa paligid natin, at kung tayo din ay hindi nakakatanggap o nakikinig sa mga taong ito. And you know, sometimes the guidance of those people around us has to be strong and firm. Walang coach na tuturuan tayong maging malambot, o sabi nga natin, palemya-lemya na lamang sa larong ito. Tuturuan niya tayo mainly by being kind, but sometimes he or she has to do and speak honest and sometimes vulgar and painful words. If we are to examine St. Paul and Jesus in our readings today, Paul was speaking to the Thessalonians as Jesus was speaking to the scribes and the Pharisees with no buts and ifs, mga walang kahiyahiyang mga salita, no sugar-coated words. Paul reminded them how night and day they've been working for them. Jesus as we continue His address to these groups, would speak to them and at least train them to hear honest and true words from them. Dahil ganyan po ang tapat na leader, hindi takot magsabi, hindi takot maghubog ng isang tao, hindi sumusuko kapag hindi nakakakita ng improvements. People who never give up. And how was this true to Saint Augustine that we all celebrate today? He may have prayed, "Late have I loved you, O beauty ever ancient, ever new." But all throughout his life, God was already working at him. Sa panahon na ginawa niya yung pinakamadilim, yung pinakamabigat na kasalanan, right there and then, God was already working at him. Paul never gave up to his communities. Jesus never gave up to those against him. To make out of the best of Augustine, God never gave up on Augustine. Hindi sinukuan ng Diyos si San Agustin. With the life of Saint Augustine, I am very much sure that there is no such thing as hopeless. Kaya lamang natin nasasabing hopeless na itong asawa ko, hopeless na itong kapatid ko, hopeless na ako, dahil ang dali po nating sumuko. Ayaw nating magbigay ng todo nating pagmamahal at ng todo nating pag-iintindi sa bawat isa. If we wish for the best of others, do not give up on others. God wants the best from you because He never gave up on you. Naging maayos, matatag at magandang tagapagturo si San Agustin kahit sa kanyang madilim na nakaraan, dahil hindi sumuko ang Diyos sa kanya. Hindi siya sinukuan ni Monica, hindi siya sinukuan ng mga tao sa paligid niya. Kaya nakita natin ang the best version sa kanya. We just need to listen and feel how the Lord can be honest and at least be vulgar through and with the people around us. We have each other to burst out the best in us. We have God and we have each other because we do not give up on each other.
Please stand.
We ask our Lord to help us to be sincere in our actions. Let our prayer be, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in our lives as members of the people of God, we may fulfill the demands of the Gospels by our consent. Constant witnessing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may avoid doing things out of the desire to conform or out of hypocrisy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those discouraged by our displeasing manners and behaviors may return to worship by our renewed life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may see the healing hand of God in their trials and difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have departed from this life may be received into eternal glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, as well as our prayers for one another. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, help us to come to worship with a sincere heart, so that we may be able to approach you in spirit and in truth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Celebrating the memorial of our salvation, we humbly beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us the sign of unity and the bond of charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Augustine, you bid your Church rejoice. So too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Augustine, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May partaking of Christ's table sanctify us, we pray, O Lord, that being made members of His body, we may become what we have received, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our host for tonight's Wednesday Family Rosary will be the parish and the community of San Roque Parish from Pasay City. We hope to gather our families tonight and continue to ask the Blessed Mother to pray for us and lead us always to the heart of her Son. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.